Sam! Sam compels the patient! Sam! Stop! Stop! Stop, Sam! Excuse me for interrupting my famous director, Sam Gefeltefish, and I know you normally know what to do, but you see, Sam, this is a special program. It's a Saturday show. We're going to be on for an hour, and we're going to be reviewing 1978. So we have to have a sign, a special announcement or something. What I need is a big card. You see, if I had a card... Ooh, I've got the card, Sam. You see, what we're going to... I need a pen. Then I would write... Oh, thank you. See, I'll write highlights. Let's see. Highlights of 1978. See, I've got that. And then we'll, and then I need a staple gun. A staple gun, and then I'll put it right up there. And not a crowbar, a staple gun. That's more like not a banana. Here it is. We'll put this up here. Highlights of 1978. We're all set. You take a picture of this, and then start everything, and here we go. Hold it, J.P. Patches, mayor of the city, don't...
me, forgot! Hi, Judas, it's me. I just thought I'd call you and see what you're doing.
Oh, hi, Gertrude, how are you?
Fine, fine.
Hey, listen, I'm glad you called.
Are you really?
You know what I've been doing for the past hour?
That's probably what I just asked you. What are you doing?
I'm writing down some New Year's resolutions.
It's about time you wrote some resolutions down, Julius. You really need resolutions after all. You know, you're sort of lax at a time. I mean, you should have goals and things to go to.
Hey, listen, Gertrude.
Yeah?
Yes, I'm writing down resolutions, but they're not my resolutions.
Well, whose are they, probably?
They're yours.
Yeah, but you're mine.
Yes. I want you to come down so I can review these resolutions with you.
I'll be right down.
Okay.
Julius, where are you? I know you're down here someplace. Oh, get out of the way, will you?
Wait.
Fred!
Wait, I've got to hang this up here. Oh, hi, Fred. Hi, Ethel. Wasn't it nice you brought your friends down
with
you?
Yeah, isn't it nice I brought my friends? Most people have dogs. Most people have other kind of animals. I got pigs.
Goodness, what happened? He straightened the curl in his tail off.
Well, let's get one of my...
Come on over here, Gertrude.
Let me see these terrific resolutions.
Yes,
you got.
And they're all yours.
All mine.
Take a look at them here.
Yeah, I can see
so
right
far,
there.
I have about nine, and I'm sure we can get more than that.
Well, what do they start with? Read it.
Well, let's see. 1979, Gertrude, New Year's resolutions.
The first one is...
Exercise.
Exercise. Good
idea.
You know,
Gertrude... You definitely are out of shape.
Well, after all, what do you mean I'm out of shape? I'm quite beautiful.
Yeah, let me see you do some deep knee bends.
All right. La, la, yeah. La, la,
deep.
La.
Deep. Knee deep, not
la,
shallow.
La, 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 la. Oh. I'll be right back to you.
Yes, oh, no, just stay right here.
What?
You know, you should be in shape like me, for example.
In shape? Yes, Judas, I probably should be in good shape. We all should be, yeah.
Yeah. As a matter of fact, I was in such good shape last year. You remember when Boris S. Wort was calling me phonio?
Oh, I remember that! Yeah,
and I had to learn how to juggle.
Yeah, and you were out of shape. But you had a lot of difficulty.
Yeah, I wasn't. I did it.
Phonio de clown.
Oh,
phonio
boy, if there was
clown.
Only something I could do. If there was only something that someone... wait! What's this?
What? Holy smokes, what's going on? What happened? What's going on today? What's everybody doing? I never saw this. Wait, hold on.
Oh, wow, look at it. Look at all the look at all the balls in the air.
They're juggling.
Everybody's juggling. Look.
Where are you? Where'd you go? I know you're around there someplace. Where'd you go?
Boris.
I know you're in there.
there someplace.
I think that the Boris.
Yes, I know you're over here.
The 15 seconds. Come on over here, Boris. 15 seconds are up.
I know you're in here.
Okay, everyone stop. Everyone stop.
Well, Boris, did you or did you not see me juggle? Did you see the balls up in the air?
I saw so many balls and stuff going up in the air, I couldn't believe it.
Well, but you couldn't what?
Believe it.
Oh, all right. Well, I guess now you'll stop calling me Phonio, huh?
Excuse me.
Yeah, okay,
I'll
all
stop
right.
Calling you
out
phonio.
The door. So long. Well, anyway,
yeah. I learned how to juggle. Of course, I knew all the time, being a famous clown of the Dingling
Did
Brothers
really?
Circus.
Yes. Oh, golly, well, that's kind of good, Julius. But, you know, I have something else I want to tell you.
Yes.
You remember, Julius, I think that you should take up a sport, something like that.
A sport?
Yeah.
Well, you see this basketball?
Uh-huh.
Well,
that's not a basketball. That's a baseball. Or, football.
Football. Yeah, that's football. What it is. You remember the time that famous football player Sonny Sixkiller was here?
Yeah, and he sure taught you how to throw a football.
Well, he did. And you were looking for him. We played a little trick on you.
Yeah, that's the problem. I couldn't find him at all, Julius. I walked in, he was gone. I walked out, he was here. I walked in, he was gone. I walked out, he was here. What happened?
Well, he was kind of hiding there. If you would have looked close enough.
I'm all set. He could come out and kiss my hand.
Yeah, well, let me say that Sonny was here.
He was here.
Yes, he was here.
Was he here?
Yes.
Good, good. Was he standing right there?
Yes, he was standing right
was
there.
Was he standing over there?
Well, no, not really.
Oh, yeah, well.
See, football? See, I think he's playing football.
Outside, probably.
Probably?
I'll go out there. Look. Good. Sonny, I know you're here!
Okay, great. Well, that was a close one, Sonny. I'm sorry.
Boy.
I don't see him on anywhere. He's not out there. I know he's not.
Oh, why don't you fade way back.
Okay, here I go,
back.
Here I go.
Back.
Back!
Watch out for the hole out there!
Julius!
I'll try and get her in the hole there. Hey, that was a lot of fun
last
year.
Yeah, that certainly was.
Why don't we do that again? Why don't you go out?
No! Not after once. You're not going to get me to do it twice. Yeah. No, sir. Reserve.
Well, you know, Sonny learned a few things from me. You know, how you handle a ball. You know, quick of foot and very sharp of eye.
Yeah.
Watch this. Well, I did a lot better that day.
I don't remember.
I showed him exactly how I did it. And
it's been a long time since I picked one of those up.
Okay, you know how to do it. I mean, you know, see. Got any, hey, how's it feel?
Oh, not bad. Is this your own? Is this your
ball? Yeah, that's, you know, I play a little around here.
Is this the one you take home when the kids won't let you play?
Yeah. Oh. Okay, let's see. You think you can throw a pass out there to the boys and girls?
Sure. Is Jack Patera watching, by the way?
He always watches. Okay,
I'll give it a try.
Okay.
Okay, here goes.
Not bad, Julius. Good old Sonny.
Yes. And he learned a lot from me. You notice what great shape he was in? Did
he
you notice?
He was in outstanding shape, Julius.
We looked like a couple of bookends there.
You certainly
did. Me with my great shape and his with...
Well, that's all right, Julius, but I'm not even going to make a comment on that.
Well, anyway, that'll be your New Year's resolution number one. We learned that in 1978.
We are going to profit
now,
by it, Julius.
We are going to talk about your pet chameleon right after this.
You mean Ponce?
Yes.
We'll return to our story in just a moment.
What a shame.
Oh, Gertrude, I have a record of all these things that happened in 1978, that's why I have this New Year's resolution list for you.
Very good idea for me, I'm actually. You're probably too. You're talking about my chameleon, Ponce, you know.
Yes.
Ponce de chameleon.
Ponce de chameleon.
Yeah, he's lovely. He's very nice. He changes colors, and no matter what sort of an environment he's in, he's a piece of chameleon, you know. But let me tell you, Mr. Smarty, what about your animals and all of that? So how do you treat your pets? How do you?
Well, I treat them Listen, come on out here, Grizz. Good boy. Grizz, tell Gertrude what a great pet owner I am.
Yeah, see ya. That's what I thought. That's what I thought. Now, why don't you go right over there and ask Gorst how he thinks about it?
Hey,
how
wait.
How he feels about last year.
Last year?
Yeah.
Well, how he well did loved
you,
it.
How well did you treat him last year, Mr. Big Nose?
Just beautifully, because every Friday I threw in some fresh purple fodder, either from Farmer Frank up in Ferndale or Farmer Fred from Fife.
That's right. I didn't think
Fine
of that.
Fellows.
Fine fellows.
Yes. And this is what happened.
Well, you're going to share.
Well, okay. Hey, don't keep all of yourself. Oh, you're going to have some. Boy, look at that. He's eating that farm fresh purple fodder. That's how they eat it. That's how purples. Can I have some? That's what I was going to say. Good stuff, eh?
Good stuff, yeah.
Well, that was pretty good stuff. Have you ever seen a purple feed on purple fodder?
I have never seen that, but I have now, and I'm happy that I did. Yeah. Julia said, another thing I want to let you know, some of the things that you should probably brush up on are, probably I see number three down here, be nice to guests.
That's for you. Yes, you should be nice to guests.
Oh, well, I know you should always be nice to guests and treat them courteously and all of that, but every once in a while, Julius, it's pretty difficult.
Well, yes, you know, even if you receive an unexpected guest, like I remember last year, Captain Zarron from the planet of Zonk arrived.
Yes, and remember what happened when he arrived.
Yes, fortunately, I was able
to speak. I know it's as hard for you to understand
me as it is for me to understand you, but here we are. Two great civilizations. You from the planet Zonk, and here I am down by the city dump, getting together. It just proves that individuals, even though they grow up in a different culture, can get along and understand each other. Right, Captain?
Captain?
Uh-oh.
Here, kid. Yeah, it must be all worth.
I guess that
means
okay.
No, we now, sister, I'll put that's how you...
Captain, I know you have to zabeam back up to your spaceship, but look, I'll try and figure out what it is could you come back maybe on Saturday or Sunday?
Well, sometime during the week.
Yes, sir, let's see your Friday or Saturday. Yes, sir,
hey, you know, when you first came down, you zabeamed down and it kind of hurt my eyes. Would you hold on just I'm going to step right behind you there, Captain. I'm going to put on my Z-Ray helmet there to protect my eyes. Okay? I'm all set. And don't say, what did you say? Come on, Captain!
Boy, Judas.
Yes.
He's scary.
Oh, very nice. And come to think of it, today is Saturday. So, you know, up on the planet of Zonk, there are certain words that start with Z.
Yes, what are they?
Well, there's a Saturday and there's Sunday, and it sounds like a cartoon right now.
How about that?
So let's zing out a cartoon to all the Patches pals. As a matter of fact, I think our cartoon is George of the Zungle.
Jungle, not Zungle.
Oh, I thought it was Zungle.
You know, Junior, you're not even
talking. Then away he'll schlep on his elephant ship while Fella and Ursula stay in step. We're George, George, George of the Jungle, friend to you and me. Watch out for that tree.
Our story opens in a miserable hut in the Bumbashooty village, where the evil witch doctor is casting a
mad. I gotta get more practice.
That's it, Gertrude. Come on out of the secret room. You what? Are vain. You are vain. You are vain.
I am not vain. I am not vain, Julius. That means you're just self-centered and ego and all of that stuff. I mean, all you do is think about yourself. That's vain, and I am not that way.
Well, not quite. You see, that's resolution number 4.
Oh,
it says, don't be vain.
Okay.
Don't be vain.
No matter where you are.
I remember that famous Olga Ospenskaya.
Oh, yeah, I remember Olga. She was nice.
Yes, you tried to make yourself young and beautiful again.
Well, every girl tries
and
to be
beautiful. And you resorted to witchcraft.
Olga knows.
Olga knows it is made just right.
Yeah.
Just a drop.
Oh, yes.
Just a drop.
Just a drop. Olga, that was more than a drop. Olga?
No. We start.
Olga, it's scary.
Yes, but have no fear. Soon you will be youthful again. You will be beautiful.
Yeah, soon beautiful.
You
soon
will be
beautiful.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Now we mix
it up. Oh, can't wait.
Only I can't wait.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, I've been waiting for this.
That's what I thought.
That's why my good friend J.P. stays so young and
beautiful. How long have you known J.P.?
Oh, all of his life, all 27 years of his life.
Olga?
Oh, there's I lose track of time.
See that a lot.
Yes, we mix it up now.
Oh, look at that
it's
stuff.
It's almost ready.
Well, Olga, I know it's got to be good.
Oh, a drop more, I can see.
Just a little bit more.
A drop more.
You do this very often?
No, not very often.
Do you know anybody named Glinda?
Glinda? Oh, soon it will be ready.
Oh, look at that.
Just a drop. Nothing more than a touch. Upon, let me check your skin tone. Oh, yes. Now you've got to be very careful. Too much and you'll become a little teeny baby again. Yeah, no. But just this small...
Yeah, listen, Olga.
Drop that there.
Yeah, that's going to be good. I can tell you that, Olga. I'm going to like that.
Yes, I'm going to like it more. Ah, there we are.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Take out the little pebbles and just a small touch. And we mix it up thoroughly.
You know, my boss is waiting, I think.
Your boss is waiting?
Yeah.
Oh, you will be so young,
oh,
you'll
yeah,
get
well.
On free.
Oh, yeah.
You get on free.
Yeah, under six.
There we go.
Hey!
Oh.
How does that look? How does it look,
you
old?
You are going to look so young. Get some more out here.
It's chilly.
Yes, I know.
Yeah.
In your case, I need a lot of elixir.
And resolution number 5.
Oh.
Be graceful, Gertrude.
I'm always graceful.
Graceful.
Miss Twinkletoes.
Be graceful. Na 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 na.
Gertrude.
Yeah. We'll see you later. Have a nice day, Julius.
Gertrude.
Yeah, hi.
Hi.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Well, only takes you half an hour to make another one. Yeah.
Yes, I remember my birthday cake.
Oh,
you
boy.
Were so graceful, Miss Twinkletoes.
Oh,
you put your foot into it. No, you put your hand into it.
That's
it
right.
Looked like your foot.
You tripped me, Judas. You tripped me. Wasn't
no,
my
I didn't.
Fault
no,
at
I didn't.
All.
No, I didn't. Yeah.
Let's see.
Well, we're halfway through the resolutions for 1979.
How am I doing?
Not very good, but you can improve. You know, anyone can improve themselves.
Well, that's good, Judas.
I'm certainly glad that I have a record of some of the things that you should have done in 1978.
Yeah, right. Well, when do we get to yours? When do we get to yours?
I have my resolutions right here.
Right there?
Yes. Well, we might look at those a little bit later.
Well, you know what's the funny thing, Julius? I mean, oh, there's Tyke.
Oh, Tikey Turkey.
Uh-huh.
Yes, and I'm glad he's here because you know what? Oh, he brought along a friend.
Well, yes, I mean,
Teeny Turkey.
Yeah, turkeys that fly together, you know.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hmm. Well, listen, I'm glad Tikey is here. Are you? Yeah, this is Tikey.
Yeah?
This is the day and age when we should conserve energy.
Yes, that's what I mean to talk to you about.
Including natural resources.
And all you do is waste water. You know that. Yeah. I have
no,
never
I don't
seen a
waste
person
water.
Waste more water than you do.
I attract water.
That's...
I don't waste it.
No, yeah.
Somehow or another.
The minute you get water, you...
Definitely is a sun dance. It definitely is a sun dance. Chief. Chief. Well, I thought it was a sun dance, Chief. Chief, I'm getting wet. Maybe you went around the wrong way or something.
Maybe that's the weather bureau.
Oh, okay. You see how...
Oh, yes. What did I tell you?
Look,
somehow or another.
It's raining. It's raining.
Quick, do something. And while we're doing something, you do something. I know what. You watch this.
You know, know, I mean, this is one thing that you've got to do, Nick. While the rain has stopped,
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure the rain has stopped.
Are you positively sure?
There ain't gonna rain anymore! No, he's shaking his head. Cool.
Well, I remember one time last year when I had this umbrella in my hand, and, well, the magic house did it to me.
It did?
Yes, it did.
Gloomy-looking skies and a bit of the wet stuff. What happened?
I'll tell you what happened. I got it right in the eye.
That's what happened.
Let's see. Is it really gone?
It's gone.
It's gone.
Now, this is what I've got to do. Julius!
All right, now. Where are we, resolutions?
Well, we're right down to the fact that you have got to do some stuff. Now, I've noticed you never do anything, Judas. I mean,
that's exactly the next resolution.
You've got to get out there, and you've got to see the public, and you've got to let them know, and you've got to shake hands with them and do a lot of stuff like that.
Hey, listen, Gertrude, I was out all last year and the year before and the year before. I have met a lot of Patches pals and a lot of people.
Well,
what have you been doing? You should do things like, you know, the Children's Orthopedic Hospital? Have you been there lately?
Well, not lately, no. I was a couple of weeks ago, but not lately.
Well, that's pretty good. As a matter of fact, some very special things happened last year.
What?
Holly Baloo in the nose of the dirigible.
Whereas for the past 20 years, J.P. Patches has delighted children all over the Seattle area, and whereas all of us in Seattle owe J.P. Patches a little extra recognition on this occasion, I, Charles Royer, Mayor of the City of Seattle, do hereby proclaim October 14th, 1978, as J.P. Patches Day in Seattle. What do you think of that?
J.P. Patches Day! Well, what do you think of that, Zenobia?
Curses! I'll be back! Don't you worry about a thing. Once again, you foiled me. And I am going to go right now, but I will return, and I'll always be flying overhead because Halloween is not very far away. You're not bad looking, you know that? You're coming with me.
Wow. Saved by Mayor Royer proclaimed J.P. Patches Day. Both of them down that secret room. Well, Patches pals, we have been saved. And speaking of J.P. Patches Day, it makes tomorrow an even bigger occasion when it is J.P. Patches Day. And Gertrude and I and Gorst, the friendly purple officer friendly, will all be down at the Seattle Center. And what a day that was, Gertrude. October 14th, Mayor Royer proclaimed as J.P. Patches Day. And, of course, you had a great time. And Officer Friendly and some very nice people from Children's Orthopedic Hospital.
Yeah.
And look at the people.
Julius,
over 4,000 Patches Pals.
Yeah.
Big Patches Pals, little Patches Pals, medium-sized Patches Pals. A lot of Patches Pals.
All over, Julius. You just never saw so many kids having such a lot of fun.
You know, it didn't rain that day. The weather really cooperated.
You know what it did? It rained a lot of friendship and love, Julius. That everyone just thought you were so nice.
Thank you, Gertrude.
They liked
me, too.
We really
had a great time. And you know what?
What?
You were gorgeous that day.
I thought I looked nice.
You really were. In fact, I heard people saying some very nice things about you.
Well, that's kind, Julius, but then,
as a postscript to the J.P. Patches 20th anniversary special, J.P. has received a very special award.
Come in. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Hi, who are you?
I'm Mrs. Bixby from the Children's Orthopedic Hospital, and this is Dr. Bergman.
Hello,
nice
J.P.
meeting you, Dr. Bergman.
Mrs.
Bixby?
That's right.
Okay.
We have a little presentation to make. The contribution which you, as J.P. Patches, have made to the children of the Northwest is legendary. The time and energy you have donated to the children who have been and are now patients at Children's Orthopedic Hospital and Medical Center has gone without notice except to the children with whom you have visited and the doctors and nurses who look to you for help in easing the trauma brought about by serious childhood illnesses. The Board of Trustees of the Children's Orthopedic Hospital and Medical Center wants to thank you in a very tangible way. Action has been taken by the board to name an area of the hospital's Phase 2 building program in your honor. The selected facility is appropriately a play area which will be designed to provide activities for children who visit the hospital's outpatient clinics, plus a separate adjoining space where medical personnel may observe the child at play as a part of the child's diagnostic workup. The facility will be called the J.P. Patches Play Area. A committee of the board is now working to arrange activities for the Children's Orthopedic Hospital and Medical Center Salute to J.P. Patches to be held this summer, and will provide an opportunity for the many thousands of your friends to join us in this tribute. In thanking you in this manner, the hospital parts with a long-standing tradition. We have never named a facility to recognize an individual outside the hospital family for outstanding service. We hope this singular honor will convey in some small way our gratitude for your 20 years of bringing joy to children of all ages.
Wow.
And here is a certificate.
Boy, that's the longest I've been on TV where I haven't said anything.
It's the longest I've had to say anything on TV, too.
I'm not going to say anything. I just can't. And you know what? I couldn't say anything, so I had this other fella, Chris whatever his name was. I had that fella go in my place and do all the talking there for me.
There's some very famous people right there, too.
Yes, that was a wonderful night. J.P. Patch's night. Well, I couldn't make it. Whatever his name was, he was there.
Yeah.
Very fine fellow.
I'm happy to hear that, Junius. We all thought you were so nice. Couldn't understand why you didn't show up, though.
Yeah. Oh, by the way.
What?
You know, one of the fun things that happened in 1978, to kind of get away from your resolution, was that special 20th anniversary program.
Oh, I remember that.
You remember it was Kooky Encounters of the Clown Kind.
Can't you remember anything?
Yes, I remember how it started, and it was very funny to watch.
Exactly.
Yes.
Oh, hi, guy. You're Mona's kid, aren't you?
Right.
Right.
Wrong.
Wrong.
What's up, Doc?
Oh, yeah.
What's up, Doc?
Pardon me.
I don't like it. Reverse it. It serves me. Dick, I'll know it out.
This program was recorded.
And play on the freeway.
Holy rubbish.
That's all, folks.
Is that really all, folks? Really?
Oh, no, we've got more resolutions for you.
That's good, Judith. That kid tried to
them. Well, let's see here. A new career.
That's right.
We're going to talk about Gertrude's new career, but right now... Yes.
Okay, good. What do you got in mind?
Well, I have a Tom Slick cartoon.
Do you really?
Yes. Would you like to watch it?
Yeah, what's his girlfriend's name?
Yeah, let's see. It's around here somewhere. Oh, here it is. Right here in my cartoon hat. Here we go.
Hi, Gwick.
Yes, you know, Gertrude.
What?
To broaden yourself, open up new horizons.
That's right, Julius.
New vistas.
Right.
And take a new interest in people.
Exactly, Julius.
Sometimes,
that's what you should do.
Sometimes you should get a new job.
A new job? That's a good idea. Why don't you get a new job?
Yeah. No, no, not me.
Oh, yeah?
I'm talking about you.
Oh, yeah, I ought to get a new job. What would you suggest, Julius?
Well, you know, I remember you did pretty well last year when you were a Husky cheerleader.
That's right. Why didn't they think that? Zis boom bah, our team, yaha.
Hey, you did real well.
Very good, I guess.
Especially the final test.
Yeah, I remember.
Gertrude, you you know what? I called Harry Wappler.
Yeah.
And we can't get any snow.
Oh, you can't. Well, doggone, that's too bad. Well,
no, wait.
I'm on my way to the stadium. They need me.
Wait, you have not passed the most important part of the test, because in the event it snows, you know, if you're not smiling,
You know, you're not a Washington cheerleader.
You don't worry about that, police.
Okay.
Well,
so,
that's it. Right.
In lieu of not having snow.
What?
We have some pie whipping.
Would you hurry?
Yes, we have some pie whipping cream here, and we will pretend this is snow.
Yeah.
Now let's see the smile. Okay. All right. Are you ready? Oh, Gertrude, you are great. Okay, this is the last test. Now give it all you've got. I will just put a little snow. There comes the snow. Yes, here's the snow. Oh, here it comes. It's coming down in bucketfuls. Okay. All right. There's the snow. Okay. Hold it there, Gertrude. Gertrude,
yeah.
We're going to find out if you pass the test. Did Gertrude pass the test? They're getting into a huddle. Just wait, Gertrude.
No.
357
okay.
To the left.
I heard one no.
No? Okay. Wait a minute.
I heard a yes.
Yeah. All I need is another yes, and I got it.
One no and one yes. We need a tiebreaker.
Here you go. Yep.
Hey!
I did it!
Gertrude, do it.
Gertrude did it.
So.
We're gonna make her an honorary cheerleader.
Hey, thanks a lot, an honorary cheerleader.
An honorary cheerleader. Nice hand for Gertrude.
Yeah.
Gertrude,
yeah.
You did a wonderful job and you're still smiling.
Oh, Dad. Wait a minute, Judas! I'm not supposed to do that right. It was snowing that day, you know. You didn't tell me it was going to snow at all.
Oh, did someone do that to you?
Right at the last minute, you know.
This magic house, you never know what to expect.
Well, you know, Judas, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these things and I'm going to go.
Wait, these resolutions. We haven't ended with these resolutions.
Haven't you yet?
Oh, here's one that's very important. Very important.
Very important.
Yes, okay. Be on time.
Be on time. That is the most important time, Judas. And I've known you be a little tardy.
No. Okay, where are we going to be today?
Today, we're going to be on... Oh, I forgot.
Yeah, see? We're going to be at Holiday Foods out in Federal Way.
Really?
Yes.
What time?
Time.
Yes, time.
10 o'clock.
10 o'clock, yes. Holiday Foods in Federal Way. Yes.
You know, it's funny. Whenever I give the time, you always hear a ding.
Yeah, why is that?
Well, I don't know. It's a magic house. 10 o'clock. Did you hear that?
How about that?
Okay, we're going to be at Holiday Foods today, and that's the Holiday Foods out at
Federal Way.
Federal Way.
Good.
At 10 o'clock.
Yeah, good. And it's time to move on.
Yeah. Now, there's another very, very important one.
Yes, I know.
Yes, very, very important. Huh? This is the last resolution.
The very last one.
And it's going to take some time to explain to you, so while I'm...
Oh, I mentioned time again.
And while I'm doing it, I want
he's standing there talking. Let's take a look at this, and we'll be right back.
I was just going to say that. Okay, now, as I was explaining, but you can stop dancing, Gertrude.
That's one of my favorite songs.
Resolution number 10. That's the final one.
Let's get down to the final, the big one.
Be nice to Patch's pals.
That's right. Be nice to Patch's pals.
You're nice to the Gertrude gang.
Yeah, I would
But you're
know.
Not nice to Patch's pals.
Well, what about the Boris buddies?
Well, you should be nice to them, too.
Be nice to everybody.
Okay.
Good.
As a matter of fact, I remember there were a couple of Patch's pals who came down.
Uh-huh.
And you have to talk to them. You have to find out what they're thinking. And they can tell you a few things. You can learn from the Patch's pals.
Outstanding.
Didn't talk much.
Beats me.
Okay, come on right over here. And what is your name again?
Bo.
And how long you been a Patch's pal?
Most of 1978.
Most of 19. What happened there in between there? Were you a Boris buddy for a while?
No, I do not personally like to be a Boris buddy.
Well, I'm glad to hear that because that would really upset me. How's David? Is David he doesn't talk much though, does he? Can you say hi, Dave? There, okay. He hardly moved his mouth. Is he a ventriloquist?
The day before yesterday, he came close to being broken out with the chicken pox.
Close to, well, what happened? He doesn't have the chicken pox, huh?
No. He had a bad headache and...
Uh-huh.
He had to, you know, he gets home at around about 3:15 in the afternoon.
Where's he been all day? Has he been working?
No, he's been, usually, well, dilly-dallying.
Dilly-dallying around, huh?
Well, you see, Gertrude, if you're nice to Patches, pals, they'll be nice to you.
Well, that's right, Junior, so just go ahead and give me the rest of the list.
Okay, take all those resolutions. All right. There we go.
Well, I hope 1979 is going to be a great year for you, Patches, pals.
Well, it sounds like Miss Smith. Find it. Here we go.
Seven different saints. Get rid of the
boy. I hope we have time.
Red, 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 red. Once again, it's time for the Miss Smith joke time.
Well, I'll quickly review the rules.
Yeah, go over it, will you?
You see, you tell a joke, and the object of the game is to get a... rather than a... Okay, if you get two, you win. If you get two, you lose. So try and get a... rather than a... Okay, quickly now.
Okay, all set?
Yes.
Where does a general keep his armies?
Where does a general keep his armies? I give up where?
Up his sleeves.
Up his sleeves. Let's see, was that joke a... or a... it was a... oh, you got one. If you get another, you win. Okay.
When is an egg like an elephant?
When is an egg like an elephant?
Well, if you don't know, I'm not going to send you to the store to get any eggs.
Oh, wow, was that joke a... or a... it was a... oh, an automatic, you got two. That means you must pay the consequences.
Wait a minute. No, that's not
you
right. I got
sorry.
More
thank
here.
You, Tikey Turkey. Tikey Turkey made this just for you, okay? There we go. But time to go. We'll see you next Saturday, Patches Bells, at 7:30. Bye-bye. Thank you.